The universe that we can see is the circular distance that encompasses everything that we can observe from our planet, with a diameter of around 90 billion light years. A light year is a unit for measuring distance, not time, as many people mistakenly believe. It is the distance that light travels in empty space in 1 year, and the speed of light is 300,000 kilometers per second, which means about 1 billion kilometers per hour. Multiply that by 24 hours, and you get the speed of light per day. Multiply them by 365, and you get the light year. At a minimum, the observable universe contains 100 billion galaxies, like the Milky Way, and each galaxy has at least 100 billion stars, which means that there are roughly 100,000 stars for every grain of sand on Earth's surface. After the launch of the Kepler Space Telescope in 2009, which is designed to explore the existence of life elsewhere in the universe, it was proven that there are many planets, and that most of these stars have planets orbiting them, just like the planets of our solar system orbit the Sun. This means that the universe contains trillions of planets suitable for life, which theoretically means that there should be life in many places in the universe other than Earth. But after all this talk, where are the aliens? Welcome. I am Ahmed Mahmoud. But before we start, if you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe and activate the bell so that our videos reach you first. In this episode, we will discuss Fermi Paradox. In the beginning, to define our scope. If we hypothetically assume that there is a civilization in another galaxy besides the Milky Way, we will never be able to contact this civilization, and in fact anything beyond our local group is unreachable forever. And the local group is a group that consists of about 30 galaxies, including the Milky Way, and the reason for this is that if we built very fast spaceships, they would take billions of years to reach other galaxies, and the reason for that is the cosmic expansion according to the Big Bang theory. So let's focus on the Milky Way only, which has planet Earth. Our galaxy has about 400 billion stars, of which about 20 billion stars are similar to our Sun, and expectations say that about 4 billion stars of them have planets around them, the size of which is similar to the size of planet Earth, and they also fall in the Goldilocks zone, which is the region suitable for life. And the region suitable for life, for those who do not know, is the region where the Sun's temperature allows the presence of water in its liquid form. And if we say that one out of every 1,000 planets suitable for life actually had life on it, then we have about 4 million planets that are supposed to have life on them. And this is only in the Milky Way. And the age of the Milky Way is approximately 13 billion years. And after about 2 billion years from the beginning of its formation, the many explosions calmed down, and the first planets suitable for life emerged. And since the age of the Earth is about 4 billion years, this means that there were many chances for other planets older than Earth to have life on them. But I wonder, if there was a civilization older than human civilization, what would it look like? According to the Kardashev Scale for measuring the level of technological advancement of civilizations, the civilizations are divided into three categories. Type 1 civilization, or civilization of the first type, which is the civilization that can use and exploit all types of energy available on the planet on which it is located. And humans are currently estimated to be 75% of the first type, meaning that 25% more, and we become a civilization of the second type. And expectations say that this may happen within the next 200 years. As for the Type 2 civilization, or civilization of the second type, it is the civilization that can use all the energy of the star that its planet orbits, such as the Sun for us. And the Type 3 civilization, or civilization of the third type, is the civilization that dominates an entire galaxy and all its energy and resources. And if humans reach the technology that they could build giant spacecraft that could transport large groups to colonize other planets other than planet Earth, we could colonize the entire Milky Way within 2 million years, and despite the astronomical number. But stay with me. Let's not forget that the age of the galaxy is 13 billion years, and 2 million years in its age are considered nothing. This means that, if there were civilizations on other planets, these civilizations could be older than human civilization by billions of years. And by that, it would be possible for a civilization of these civilizations to reach that. It is of the third type and, as we said, that the entire galaxy needs only 2 million years to be fully colonized, meaning that they are supposed to have reached the stage of colonizing the entire galaxy. But the question remains, where are they? This is Fermi's paradox, and no one has a certain answer to it until today. But there are some hypotheses, and the first thing is the filter hypothesis. The filters or sieves are a very huge event that makes it hard for life to continue after it, such as maybe the universe in the past had many explosions that made it unstable, and any chance for life was wasted because these planets were hit by meteors or something else. And the universe calmed down recently, and humans are the first civilization in the whole universe and humanity itself passed by several filters until now, such as the nuclear war that could have eliminated all humanity, or maybe in the future, a country invents a type of weapons that destroys all humanity, and by that it is possible that there were many civilizations that lived and died, and maybe we are also alone. And until now there is no evidence of the existence of any life anywhere in this huge universe, except on Earth, and this means that maybe humans are very special, and maybe they are indeed the only creation, or maybe we are until now the first civilization and the day comes, and we turn into a civilization of the third type and colonize the entire galaxy. But that's it. We're done. Who reached here? All those who reached are the best people. If you liked the video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. If you want to see more videos like this, and see you in the next episode. Have a good night. Bye.